All right, our first guest this evening joins us on the phone. He's here not only to talk about the current stimulus, but looking ahead at what's coming down the road. As I said, perhaps another $3 or $4 trillion, and how to pay for it without totally wrecking the economy. Joining us now is Senator Mike Braun from Indiana. Senator Braun, thanks for coming on. I want to get to the Joe Manchin infrastructure, but first, your quick take, your final thoughts on this stimulus package, because I know you're about as thrilled with it as I am.
Well, what you just were talking about in terms of the long-term implications, there aren't many in the U.S. Senate, sadly, that think that way, Larry, because we wouldn't be running structural trillion-dollar deficits driven by dumping money from the general fund into Medicare and Social Security and all that. That impending consequence is significant. But this stimulus bill, let's just look at what happened here a few days ago. Thank goodness Ron Johnson required it to be read. That gave everybody a little bit of time to dig into the details of it. We did trot out a bunch of amendments to expose all the stuff that was unrelated to public health and COVID. But Manchin then came in, and yes, they delayed it another 10 to 11 hours simply because among themselves, they didn't want to give up on the $400 unemployment enhanced check running through September, and then came up with a trick of changing it to $300, but then making some of it not subject to taxes. That just tells you how good politicians in D.C. have gotten at confusing things, putting a smokescreen out there. And this stimulus package, when you look at all the policy that's embedded in it, that's one thing. It needs more than 11 hours to be vetted properly. But I'm mostly worried about what the Democrats are talking about in terms of completely going back to what are the implications in the long run. Every bit of this, we've borrowed every penny to pay for it, just like we did the $4 trillion prior to it, of which a trillion hasn't been spent or obligated. So if it weren't for the fact that we were the only reserve currency out there and we're feeling no pain currently, you now have this thing called the modern monetary theory that they're trying to use to rationalize it.
That's great. I was just going to mention the modern monetary theory.
Pains me to think about what happens down the road.
But, Senator, let me, I love that. Some night we're going to have to spend some time on this crazy modern monetary theory that says you can spend, borrow, and print money as much as you want. But, Senator, I want to focus for a moment on the next stimulus bill. $3 to $4 trillion, or who knows? The sky's the limit. And Senator Manchin, who runs the Energy Committee, will, basically be one of the key points to shepherd this thing through. But Senator Braun, my point is, $3 to $4 trillion on top of what we just did, and the only way to deal with the pay-fors will be taxes. You're looking at repealing the Trump tax cuts. You're looking at a carbon tax. You're looking at a national gasoline tax. I don't care what people say. Now, that is truly an economy wrecker, in my judgment. What's going to happen here? What's going to go on here? And will Republicans be involved in this?
So they're going to use this, not under the smokescreen of public health or COVID, but it's going to be infrastructure, which obviously everyone is for. Our infrastructure is ailing across roads and bridges, rail, air, waterways. But how do you pay for it? At least in infrastructure, if you had the political will, you've got user fees. We did it back in Indiana. We've got a good stream of cash flow because we're the crossroads of America, but there's no political will in D.C. to even do that. You're right. You'd have to raise taxes. I think general taxes are a little different than taxes you generate through use of whatever you're spending the money on. But regardless, it'll probably be done the same way because I don't think they'll have the political will to raise gas and diesel taxes or fees on waterways or on airlines. And yes, we'll print the money, so to speak. We'll borrow it, and it'll even compound it. So
but
that
Senator,
will be the next thing they try to do because they know it's politically popular.
But Senator,
just like stimulus checks and enhanced unemployment and all the other
but Senator, hang on a second,
will be,
sir.
And we've got to articulate
Senator
that that's going to end up causing a major issue down the road.
There's
but
gonna,
yes,
this
we'll
is going to be
next, and it'll probably be for them similar in terms of how they get it through, because they know it has general appeal, even though you never talk about the details of how you're going to pay for it.
Well,
sadly,
the biggest thing here, just the last word, it's going to be about renewables, and it's going to be about the end of fossil fuels. So the energy sector is going to be very badly damaged, which will hurt our economy at home, will cause a tremendous job loss, and will also help our enemies abroad. That's the key.
All of that is true, and we just reached energy independence. And anything that's done on climate needs to be taken into account what the biggest emitters are doing, India and especially China. China's building a coal-fired plant generally weekly, and they're off the hook with the Paris Accord agreement for 10 years after all the rest of us that have been towing the line.
Right.
So there's a lot of stuff out
Thank
there.
Thank you,
that,
Senator. Thank you very much.
Now,
I appreciate you coming on, Senator Braun.
We got to
jump. I don't know, perhaps you can't hear me. We got to jump. I appreciate you coming on the show very much. Now,